I'm lucky I get to go to Australia about once a year. It's pretty cool. It's a long flight, though. It's a long flight. Are you Australian or just crazy? Just crazy. Okay. Which makes you Australian. That's a long flight to Australia. It's a 16-hour flight. It's a long flight. You got to do something if you're going to take that flight, right? You got to medicate. I drink a bottle of wine, pop a Xanax, and eat a weed edible. That's what I do. Or as they call it in the aviation business, the Anna Nicole Smith. It is. Lights out. That's... You guys are more hurt by the Anna Nicole Smith joke than the Steve Jobs one. That's on you. I love going to Australia. My favorite part, aside from doing shows there, is hanging out with the wildlife. Because the wildlife they got there is wild, man. They're not telling us about it. They got a bird there called the magpie, right? The magpie, during certain seasons, will dive bomb at people's eyeballs. I found out about this in a park after I smoked a joint during dive bombing season. I was like, wait, what do I do? He goes, mate, look right at him. I was like, I will not look right at him. What are you talking about? I'm not taking the target to the archer. Now, the best animal they got there by far is this animal called the quokka. There's some of them here tonight, obviously. Now, quokka, for those of you who don't know, cutest animal on earth, okay? They really are. Right? Basically, picture a squirrel and a guinea pig getting merged together, but even then, that's not doing it justice. They look CGI'd. Cute, right? So I found out about these things. There's an island of them. So I go with my buddy Dave, the guy I do the podcast with that I won't shut up about, right? So we go to this island. We're going to hang out with them all day, right? I'm very excited. But on the way out there, I find out an even more delicious detail, which is that quokkas, when you take pictures with them, smile. They smile. It's nuts. They're just like, hey, it's true. Look it up. Look it up on your dumb phones that are ruining civilization when you leave here. You'll see them. So I'm very excited to go to this island and hang out with smiling quokkas, right? But we get there, and it's a different story. The quokkas are not into it. They're running away from people. They're skittish. They don't like it. And we find out the reason why. The reason why is because people used to kick them. Yeah, that's right. Australians. They're psychos. I don't know what to tell you. Now... they did call it quokka soccer, which is technically funny. Pains me to say, it's an abhorrent act, but funny is funny. Gotta be fair. So the quokkas have sort of moana'd this information into new generations of quokkas, so now new generations of quokkas know don't trust humans, they're dicks. So Dave and I are getting the brunt of this. We spent 2 hours trying to get pictures with these quokkas, nothing, snake eyes, right? So we've eventually given up, we're leaving the island, we're walking away. I see a pack of like 12 quokkas, and I decide to approach, right? Now, as I do, 11 of them got the memo about the kicking. They run off. But one of them, something's off with him. He's just standing there like, what's up? And I'm like, Dave, look at this little guy. I'm gonna pet him. He goes, are you supposed to? I go, Give him a little head rub. He loves it. He's staying put. He's like, So then I move the party to the chin, give him a little chin music. He's into that even more. His eyes close, he's like, About 10 minutes after that, this dude is just standing up sleeping on my hand. Standing up sleeping on my hand. I'm like, what did I do to deserve this? Now Dave, he's over here taking pictures of me, but he starts to get a little jealous, you know? He's like, I want to tag in. I'm like, tag in? I don't know if that's how this works, dude. I don't know if you just get to WWF into my magical moments whenever you feel like it, like a quantum leaper. But I'm like, if we're gonna do it, we're gonna do this right, okay? We're gonna Indiana Jones, Raiders of the Lost Ark, bag of sand for the idol, transfer the weight. We're not gonna disturb the quokka, we're gonna slowly transfer the weight under the chin, so we go under the chin, we slowly transfer the weight. Quokka doesn't know any better, now he's sleeping on Dave's hand. But now my wheels are turning. I'm like, what is the ceiling on a moment like this? So I'm like, I'm gonna pick him up. Dave's like, I don't think that's a good idea. I go, I don't care what you think. I believe in God now. I'm picking him up. So I bend down, scoop him up. He is into it. He loves it. His eyes are closed, right? He's got his nose buried deep into my bosom. Deep, deep into my bosom. His nose is so deep into my bosom, I feel like he might try to get milk out of me. And by God, if he can get it, he can have it, gang. Are you kidding me? Come on. I'll walk around for the rest of my life with one weird nipple and the best reason why. I'll be at a pool party 10 years from now, shirt off, rocking a sagger, you know? Someone's like, hey, did you get that nipple pierced? Be like, oh no, a quokka teated milk from me. Give me a beer. I'm living my best life. I'm king of the world. Look at tits now, mommy. So that goes on for about 20 minutes, right? And eventually we got to get going, you know, so I set him down. He's just sort of standing there looking up at me like, Papa. And you know, at this point, the other 11 quokkas from earlier are looking on like, oh no, Andy's about to get kicked. They're Australian too, I'm assuming. So I look down, I go, well, I gotta go, best friend, you know? And we walk away. And I am touched by the moment. Animals have such a hard existence in this world. They need allies, right? And there's something really beautiful to me about the fact that we don't know each other. He shouldn't trust me. He does. I don't betray it. And our souls high five. That's magic, right? So I'm walking away, buzzing. And before we leave, we go into this little cafeteria. And I go up to the lady working behind it, and I go, I just held a quokka in my arms for 20 minutes. She goes, you did what? I said, I just held a quokka in my arms for 20 minutes. She goes, quokkas, now you don't want to hold them. They're riddled with disease. I was like, what the fuck did you just say? She said they're riddled with disease. They got salmonella, chlamydia. I'm like, did you just fucking say chlamydia to me? What? No wonder he's so docile sleeping on people's hands. He's dying. So I went out back and I kicked 30 till I found him. I had no choice. I had to. No, I'm kidding. I would never, never. No. Truth is, I already had chlamydia, so the joke was on her. I was like, pfft. I was probably giving it to those things. Guys, it means a lot you came out. I really, really appreciate it.